Greetings, internet people, and thanks for tuning in. I am Alaska Crypto Guy, and this video is part of my Be Your Own VPS series. In the previous video, we downloaded and installed Microsoft Hyper-V server onto a server we built from an older Dell desktop computer. Today, I will show you how to configure the server core site of Microsoft's free Hyper-V server 2016. Let's start by booting the newly installed server. In the previous video, I warned viewers that the Hyper-V server is the core installation and does not have a graphical user interface. Basic configuration of the server must be performed through PowerShell on the command line. Don't let that make you nervous. It is actually pretty straightforward. For the more advanced configuration of the server, you will be connecting remotely to the server from another Windows desktop. These programs will be covered in a later video. The Hyper-V server core interface consists of two windows that come up when you log into the server. The blue one is the server configuration window. This page contains several essential settings that tell your server how to behave. The second window is a black terminal, which launches the command line. If you accidentally close the blue server configuration utility, you may get it back by typing sconfig into the command prompt. Let's start configuring the server. For this, I like to start from the bottom and work my way up the list. The order doesn't really matter a whole lot. Type 10 into the server configuration page and press enter. This will bring up the Microsoft Telemetry settings. As I read the info box that pops up, telemetry sounds a lot like tracking or information gathering that doesn't sound particularly necessary. Click yes and then type the number 1 and press enter to restrict the amount of information your server will report back to Microsoft. Next, we will configure the date and time settings of your server. If the date or time on your server is off by even as little as a few minutes, it can cause connectivity problems on your network. Let's start by changing the time zone to your local time zone. Then click the Internet Time tab and force an update of the time by clicking Update Now and wait for it to complete before you click OK. Click OK a second time to close out of the Datum Time settings. Type 8 and press Enter to open the network settings configuration. I only have one network connection on this computer, but if you are going to host lots of different virtual machines that use a lot of bandwidth, you may want to install a second network card in your computer. Type 1 to enter the settings for the first network adapter in the list. We are going to configure a static IP address on this machine. Type 1 again and press enter to configure its address. Type S for a static IP address, then type the static IP address and subnet mask you want and press enter. You'll also need to enter a default gateway. If you have IPv6 on your network, you'll see an address listed after your IPv4 addresses. IPv6 allows you to host multiple master nodes on the same virtual machine. So if you do not have this on your network, you may want to add it. I will create a video about how to do this in the near future. Type 4 to return to the main menu. Type 7 to enable remote desktop. Then type E to enable and press enter. Since we are going to be configuring this server remotely, it is important to enable remote desktop. Then type 1 and press enter to require clients to use more secure connections when connecting to your server. You will see a dialog box that tells you when remote desktop has been successfully enabled. Click OK to close that one. Let's enter Windows update settings by typing 5 and pressing enter. The default setting is download only, which is the best of the options for my needs. To keep the default setting, type D and press enter, or just skip configuring this section. There are just a few simple changes left and you will be done with this part of the setup. Type 4 and press enter to configure remote management settings. Remote management is enabled by default on this system and that is okay. I also like to instruct my server to reply to pings from other devices on my network because I find it aids in configuration. Type 3 and then click yes to allow the server to respond to ping commands. Then type 4 to return to the main configuration page. At this point, let's add a new administrator account that we will use to remotely configure this server. Type 3 and press enter. Then type a name for the new user account and enter a password for the account by typing a password twice and pressing enter. Next, we are going to configure the computer's name, so type 2 and press enter. Then type a computer name, I am using HyperVPS because it makes sense to do so, and press enter. Your computer will direct you to restart before those changes take effect, but we will do that a bit later, so click no here to continue setup. The last setup from the server configuration page is to set the name of the computer's workgroup. Type 1 to enter workgroup setup, and then type W to choose workgroup instead of domain, and then type the name of your workgroup and press enter to join the workgroup. At this time I am going to reboot the computer, so type 12 and press enter, then click the yes button to continue restarting this computer to apply all of the settings changes that we just configured. The computer should restart quickly. After this reboot, let's sign in and then type 6 and press enter to download and install updates. I usually use A for all updates and then let it search for and install them. I have accelerated this process dramatically to save time in the video. It took almost 15 minutes for the computer to detect available updates, and then almost another hour to download and install the updates. This is a great time to make a cup of coffee, have lunch, or do something else with your time while keeping an eye on the computer to keep it on task. A computer restart is required to complete the installation of these updates, and there are several minutes of additional configuration required after the restart. After it has finished and you are logged back in, enter download and install update again to install additional updates that were missed in the first pass. Repeat this a couple of times until your server has installed all of the detected updates. Some features, such as remote desktop, will not work until the security updates are installed. Do not skip this step. After all of the Windows updates have been installed, log back into the computer with the new admin account that you created earlier. We are going to need to enter a few commands into the command line to get everything set up properly, because it can be really inconvenient to have your user's password expire on the server. I find it easiest to just disable password expiration on the server. To do this, enter the command shown on the screen at the command prompt and press enter. You will get a message that the command completed successfully. After troubleshooting what had been slowing down a previous Hyper-V server, I found that they perform better when I uninstall Windows Defender. I do not think of this as a huge security risk, because my virtual machines will each be responsible for the security of their own processes. To remove Windows Defender from the server, type PowerShell to move from the command prompt into a PowerShell prompt. Then type the command exactly as I have written it here and watch while the uninstallation is completed. The last step of today's configuration is to enter some firewall rules on the server, which are required in order to remotely configure this server using the Server Manager application from another computer. These four firewall rules must be entered exactly as I have written them here. Type them out and then press enter after each. You will not get a confirmation message after pressing enter. If you do not get an error message, then you have entered them correctly. After you have entered the firewall rules, restart the server to commit the changes. I think we have accomplished quite a bit for one day, so at this point it is safe to go ahead and shut down the computer and take a break. If you have any questions or comments, please let me know what you think below. In the next video, we will configure another Windows computer to remotely connect to and manage this Hyper-V server, and then get this server ready to host some virtual machines. Until then, remember,
don't be afraid to push buttons. You never know what might happen if you do.